वेलकम बैक अगेन विद अ न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ हिस्ट्री। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ ग्रेट पर्सन विदाउट हुम द स्प्रेड ऑफ वुमेन एजुकेशन वुड नॉट हैव बीन पॉसिबल। दैट मैन इज ईश्वर चंद्र विद्यासागर, द सन ऑफ ठाकुरदास बंदोपाध्याय एंड भगवती देवी। Ishwar Chandra was a Bengali reformer who played a key role in the Bengal Renaissance. He was a man of multiple skills and talents. He was an academic educator, philosopher, printer, philanthropist, translator, and a publisher. He was born on 26 September in 1820 at Birsinga village in a poor Brahmin family. This village is at the Paschim Midnapur district in Bengal province. He began his study by joining a local school called Pathshala in his village. He had an incapable thirst for learning. Students, there was a story behind Ishwar Chandra's first journey to Calcutta. It was the incident of the early November in 1828. Ishwar Chandra, his thirst for learning brought him to Calcutta for further studies. Then he was only 8 years old. He came to Calcutta with his father, Thakurdas Bandopadhyay, and the village teacher. On the way of Calcutta, there were milestones on the road, and Ishwar Chandra Bandopadhyay, the little boy, followed the figures carefully on the milestones, and after a few minutes he told his father that he came to learn the English numerals. And really, it was a true story of Ishwar Chandra. Now we are talking about his education. He was not a ordinary student like others. He passed each exam with flying colors. After the village education, he continued his education at the Sanskrit College of Kolkata, where he studied for 12 years. Then he picked up a law degree and went on to join Fort William College as the head of Sanskrit department. After 5 years, in 1846, he joined the Sanskrit College as a principal. Here he opened up the door of the admission to all students, whether the Brahmin or other caste. Now, the role of Ishwar Chandra as a social reformer, as an educationist, we are learning about it. He made a lots of focus on women's education. He made a lots of effort to remove the helplessness and pains of Hindu widows. In those days, the condition of Hindu widows were quite depressing and helpless. That made him sad. He fought against the Brahmical authorities, the rituals which were against the widows. Finally, after many efforts, after many fights, he forced the British to pass the Widows' Remarriage Act in 1856. Not only that, he sought to abolish child remarriage, beat the women education. He was the first man who opened the first school for tribal girls. He opened many girls' school with his own money so that girls could study. He believed that girls are the light of society. Until they are enlightened in the light of education, society will never be free from darkness. He wrote several books for spread of education, such book as Barnaparichay, Kathamala, Bodhodaya, etc. We are proud because of Vidyasagar. He was born in this land. In addition to his studies, he was a kind man. So, we also known him in the history as Sea of Mercy. We lost a man like Vidyasagar on 29th July 1891. This is a very sad news for us, for all the people of the society. He was a great person. He was a unique one. So students, please read about Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar carefully, and I hope you feel proud about Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar. Okay, thank you.